Hi, this is Wilman Ziyada, and it is morning time here in New York City, and it is nighttime in the East. I am so excited to be once again joined on Translation by Chu Chen, and now I am joined by Dr. Lai Sang Cheong, a world-renowned calligrapher. Dr. Lai Sang Cheong, thank you so much for joining me today, and I'm so excited to just dive in. First and foremost, I want to know how your love of calligraphy began. And then off of that, because we have so much to cover, I want you to talk about your establishing of the South Asia fishing farm, where you became known as the shrimp painting specialist. And then also, I want you to dive in to talk to me about your creation of the House of Elegance Gallery.
现在是纽约时间的早晨，然后新加坡时间的晚上，很高兴您能参加我们今天的采访。然后他知道您是一位世界知名的书画家，然后在新加坡居住多年，所以呢，第一个问题是能不能跟我们分享一些过去是什么时候发现自己对书画感兴趣，然后有这方面的天赋的。 然后呢，第二个问题是，他有了解到您关于南洋渔场的一些事情，能不能跟我们，而且是被誉为是画家的我们的名家，能不能分享些那方面的情况？然后，第三个问题我可以等您先回答完，然后再提。我开始写书法呢，是在10岁左右。
后来遇到我的老师黄在林，还有黄明宗，他带领我书写这些书法，各种体型，写字呢需要也有耐心，因为毛笔字呢不容易控制，因此呢每一个人在写字的时候呢。
都要花很多长的时间来练习。我开始写字呢，到现在呢，前都有40年。赖老师，您可以都说完，这样子我们不会因为三方的网络而发生延迟。
你请你再重复一遍好不好？第一个问题是，
能分享一些您是什么时候发现自己对书画感兴趣？
第二个问题，然后他知道您成立一个南洋渔场，然后被称为我们画虾的名家，画虾的名家。我开始写字呢，是在10岁左右，后来一直跟从王在林老师学了差不多3-4年，因此呢，我的书法呢，找到一点钱，我跟朋友。 台湾的林荣华教授公司经营这个养虾场和那个蔬果场，那么在那边呢，我也得到很多学问，也得到很多金钱上的利益。好，那我先帮您把这段翻译一下。谢谢。
It began when he was 10 years old. He met some really great teacher, Mr. Huang Mingzhong, he was taught in various kind of scripts, and he believed that the calligraphy comes from the heart, not just tip of the brushwork, because it's so difficult to control the hair on the top of the brush. He spent many years just practicing and perfecting it. So it's been 4 decades now since he started learning calligraphy and painting. And about the fishery, the South Asia fishery, it was a friend of his and also a big financial sponsor for his work. And I think gradually he became the expert in shrimp painting. After observing the farm for many years.
My other question for you, Dr. Lai Sang Cheong, has to do with the creation of the House of Elegance Gallery and how that all came about for you.
Lai 老师, 他接下来一个问题是想知道 您的雅芝家画廊是如何成立的？ 然后能跟我们分享一些当时的一些情况吗？
雅芝家成立在1972年， 那时候因为我有很多画家朋友从中国来，而且有书法家的朋友教篆刻的朋友，因此我们在那个美丽华号的美丽华号都开一个雅思交换廊，那时候很多朋友从中国来都在新加坡开画展，都到我那边来雅聚。 因此我在那边跟他们学了很多东西，甚至我们在交流方面得到很多名家的鼓励和他们的那个创新。About
the House of Elegance, it was in 1972 that started to have the idea. Because a lot of friends, they're artists in China, and they frequently come to Singapore for exhibitions. He established this place as a headquarters for them to gather. And because of that, he was taught many innovative methods and many ideas and great thoughts.
I love that you say, Doctor, that you have three loves in your life: appreciation of paintings, collection of paintings, and indulging in the calligraphy culture. Talk to me a little bit about why you feel for you celebrating this art form of calligraphy specifically is so important for not only the East, but the world to get to know more about this beautiful, beautiful medium.
Hey,赖老师，他接下来一个问题，他了解到您有三大爱好，都是有关于我们书画的，包括鉴赏、收藏，然后还有传播我们的书画文化。
然后能跟我们分享一些这方面的经验吗？书法呢，要三四方面来看。第一呢，一首诗呢，先看它的那个内容；第二呢，看它们的书法；第三呢，才看它们的那个内涵。一首诗里面呢，包含着很多那个很多学问。 很多学问就是看每一个书法家的那个内涵，他们的那个学问的不一样，所以他们体会的东西也不一样。那书法呢有三个要点，就是第一点是那个要。 要那个要灵雅灵，第二点呢就是要有潇洒的那个内涵，第三点呢就是要写的章法要好。第一点我重复一下是要雅，第二点是要潇洒，第三点是要写得好，对吗？对对对。
好的，好，我来帮您翻译一下。So, regarding your next question, he gave an example of a poem. He believed that the first thing you should look at when you see a poetic calligraphy is the content, what the poem is talking about. And then it's the brushwork, how beautiful the stroke is. Last is the deeper ideas embedded in the poem. And three things that makes a good calligraphy, according to Mr. Lai Sang Cheong. First, elegance. Second, unapologetic. And third, whether the stroke is formed a unity, it has integrity, and it's how good they look together.
Wow, beautiful. Well, Dr. Lai Sang Cheong, I want to thank you so much for joining all of us today in not only spreading your amazing expertise in your background, but for reminding us that art is transcendent. You being in Singapore and me being here in the West, that your beautiful artwork is transcendent and universal. And I just want to thank you so much for your time today. And Chu, once again, thank you.